Hey, what's up, guys? Today, we're going to be looking at taking some JSON data and diving into the different properties and the different objects and arrays that live within the data and returning something specific that we want or a list of items within the data. If you like these types of videos and they're helpful, please subscribe and like the video. Comment down below if you learned something, and let's jump into it. I got a comment on one of my videos to kind of explore how to traverse and navigate through JSON data. So this is something that I struggled with a little bit when I first started to work with JSON and to work with JavaScript. So I thought I would make a video on it really quick. And I just have a index page on the right-hand side. The only thing I have within the body is a paragraph element with an ID of results. Otherwise, there's nothing here. I do have a script with some JSON. Here's a quick tip. Sometimes when you get JSON from like an API or something, it can look like this. It's completely unformatted and it's very hard to read and it's going to be hard for you to traverse. So you can use a JSON formatter if you have one on VS Code or there's some online. So like, for example, we could copy this code here and paste it into the formatter. And that way we could better navigate the structure of the JSON. So here we see we have some properties right inside the nest here, some properties, and then we have members, which have their own properties. And then within members, we have powers, which is an array of strings. So we can use this data. So we have the P tag, we have the JSON, which I just have inlined here. This is set to data. We have result element set to get element by ID results, which is the P tag ID. So we have results data.textContent equals JSON.stringify. And then within the parentheses, we just have data. This is important because if you just try to display data, it's just going to say object, object. It doesn't know what kind of data it is. It doesn't know what types it's using. Now, obviously, this is going to change depending on the data you're working with. But just for this example, we'll be using JSON.stringify. And then data is going to return all of the data. We can specify a specific property. Say we want the hometown property, which is right within the nested bracket. We would say data.hometown. That would return the string metro city. If we want the formed date, we do .formed. And that's going to return 2016. Let's say we want members. If we do .members, it will return everything within the members array. So here's all of the members. If we want to specify we want the first member, we do a square bracket indicating that we're pulling from the first item within the members array. That's going to return all of the properties associated with the first item, which is molecule. Let's go deeper. If we want the name of the first item within the members array, we set the parameter to data.members, square bracket 0.name. That returns the name. Age, secret identity, same deal. If we want the powers, this is going to return an array of strings. Set it to powers. Here's all of the powers within the first object within the members. If we want the first power, square bracket 0 is going to return just the first power. If we want the second power, set this to 1, it's going to give us the second power. Now we can do stuff like return the names of all of the members with something like a for loop to loop over the data. We can set it to the data.members.length within the for loop parameter. Return data.members, square bracket I, so this is going to be the index.name. And then this is just to create a space. We don't necessarily need this, but it's going to remove the space between the names. We could do the same with age. This is going to be a list of all the ages of the members. And we can verify that this is correct. And we can do powers. Here's all of the powers from the members. So yeah, I hope this was helpful. This applies to pretty much any vanilla JavaScript or Astro project. This is how you target the data with the period syntax here to select the specific property or the property within the object. The square bracket with the number is the index selection. So the first object is going to be square bracket 0. The second object is going to be square bracket 1. And if you want to loop over the data, you can do stuff like set a for loop with the dot length of whatever data you're returning. So in this example, we're using members to determine the amount of times the for loop runs. The members.length is going to be however many members there are within the JSON, and then return some information. So I hope I explained this well enough so that it's easy to understand. If you have any questions, feel free to post them below. And this came from a user comment on another video, and I'm doing my best to try and explain it in a way that would make sense for people. If you have web development questions that you'd like answered, feel free to leave them below and I'll try to get to them. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.